this microgreens workshop is a part of sessions which is done by Indian Empowerment Network. So let's go into details about Indian Empowerment Network. It was started by my husband Jagadeesh a few days back, and according to him, every person is unique. And this group is a peer-to-peer mentoring group that every individual can be a mentor and also a mentee. This group gives opportunity to everyone to explore their individual talents and bring out the hidden master inside you, which eventually helps in growing both professionally and personally. If you want to implement any task, then you can utilize this group and perform the task with confidence. For example, many people are giving workshops, exposing the hidden talents and empowering others at the same time, empowering themselves. The ideology behind this group to share and care, collaborate rather than compete, to spread positivity rather than judging others and spreading negativity. For the people who don't know about IEN, this is a Facebook group which was started a few days because of COVID crisis. Many people are losing their jobs and becoming hopeless. So the motto of this group is mainly to give to the individuals, raise their spirits high and prepare them for the future. Today's session is about it's like a DIY project which you're going to do now if you're having seeds. A bit about myself. I have done a master's from University of Hyderabad, India. I've done my PhD in pediatric metabolism disorders from the University of Hyderabad, University of Heidelberg, Germany. And I was volunteering as the EIT Women Munich representative and EIT Health alumnus for the period of 1 year. Then me and my husband together, we have founded For Her Well-Being organization, which is a non-profit organization, and it is mainly focused on conducting workshops and empowering women related to health and also nutrition related topics. Okay, so for today we are going to discuss what are microgreens and how they are different from sprouts. If you have any idea about microgreens, can somebody talk? Just one or two points. Nothing much.
I'm not really sure about it, but I think it's the part of some vegetables which is normally not consumed. And it's very nutritive.
Maybe we can something that we can grow at home in a small scale.
Okay. So, okay. Mm-hmm. Anyone else?
Losing your voice. Oh, no. Okay.
Okay. So, what is the nutritive value and how the nutrition differs from sprouts? And what are the health benefits of these microgreens? What are the different types of microgreens that can be usually grown? And what are the best practices to grow microgreens? Some recipes which I have done at home along with my husband using microgreens. So this I'm going to share for today. So the background pot which is there on this slide is also microgreens from moon beans. Okay, just for your information. So, what are exactly these microgreens? These are called the world's tiniest vegetables. You can just grow them in 2 to 3 days, or let's say in 1 week time. You can just cut them and munch them. They're very tasty with strong odor, and they're very nice. And actually, they give a lot of pleasant view to your eyes. And they are harvested at the seedling stage. I'll tell you in detail what is seedling stage and so on. Okay, so as the name said, it's microgreens. Micro means according to the size. They are said micro because they are very tiny. And the greens describe the wide range of vegetables that that means or salads, that means you can use almost all sorts of vegetables that to use this to grow these microgreens. And who are all interested in growing these microgreens? Mainly if you are a plant lover and if you have health consciousness, then I would recommend you to grow these microgreens in your kitchen. Specifically during this COVID-19 crisis, if you're a parent and if you have to entertain your children, it's really difficult task. So you need to actually come up with new ideas every day. So growing these microgreens would be the best idea for the kids, because they would love to explore new stuff, and they would love to see them growing, see those plants growing. Okay. So how are these microgreens different from the sprouts? Microgreens are actually having health benefits similar to sprouts, but the nutritional value when you compare with sprouts, it's much more higher. And the sprouts, you're actually soaking them overnight, and then you're going to pack them in muslin cloth or some sprout maker, and in one day you're get to go you're ready to eat those. There's no soil or there's no sunlight involved. Contrary to this, microgreens, you grow them in soil or whatever growth medium it is. Just now we used cocopeat, and after 2-3 days of growing, they need sunlight because they need to get the nourishment from the sunlight. They need to do photosynthesis, and they need to produce their own food, and that's when they are getting packed with abundant amount of nutrients, which are phytonutrients. That's when they are becoming healthier than sprouts. So the nutritional amount in microgreens is much more higher. That's what I wanted to say. So it takes average of 5 to 20 days to harvest these microgreens. That is incubation time. I mean, the day from which you soak the seeds to the day you harvest, it is like 5 to 20 days. It means it depends upon the type of seeds which you're sowing. For example, just now we sowed these cress seeds. They take just 5 days to grow into these tiny seedlings. Okay, the next picture which I'm going to show is the microgreens which I have grown in my house 3 days back. My sister took a picture. It's really beautiful the way how they're growing. So, okay, here you can see different stages of growth in this picture. So, if you can see my cursor, so this is only the seed. And first day when you're sowing the seeds, they look like this, and on the second day they just gave out root have gone already inside, and they are giving the shoot out. And these are the cotyledons. They are the, like, they look like leaves, but they're not leaves. They're cotyledons which absorb the energy from the sunlight, and they boost the plant to grow into a plantlet or into a seedling. That is the first picture where you saw here into this stage. So these are the cotyledons. They take the energy from the sunlight and give the plant, and it grows into leaflets, which are called the true leaves. Okay, so next, nutritive value of microgreens. These tiny plantlets have the entire energy focused and concentrated in the seedlings, that is in the leaflets and in the stem. So you can just eat the stem and the leaf like that directly, without cooking or without doing any preparation, any sort of preparation. And it seems that the nutrient value of this microgreens is 40 times more than its fully grown counterparts. For example, if you see broccoli, the amount of nutrients in the original broccoli vegetable is much more lesser when compared to the microgreen broccoli microgreens. So I mean, this differs again depending upon the type of microgreens which you're using, because sometimes the counterparts have much more nutrients than the microgreens. And these microgreens are very rich in antioxidants like polyphenols, vitamins, minerals, many more. Actually, so these are packed with so many nutrients that you can, if you eat those, then you can fulfill your nutrition value of that day. Okay, what are the health benefits of these microgreens? Yeah, somebody.
Yeah, I just.
Okay, health benefits of these microgreens. Since it is packed with lots of antioxidants and polyphenols, vitamins, minerals, which are all essential for the growth, for the normal growth of our body, it reduces the risk of many diseases, which are mentioned here. And also stress and aging is also one of the risk factors that are getting reduced. So why I stress much on these microgreens is that if you're growing those in your kitchen, the green color has this pleasant view. Green is called as nature's color, and like it's very soothing, cheerful, and health giving. So it's so nice when you have these greenery around in your kitchen or in your balcony. So the plants have life, and you know they talk when you greet them. It's so nice. So it's good to have microgreens, whatever plants in your balcony. And these are the different types of microgreens which I have grown in Germany when I was in Germany. So the first picture is the methi, the fenugreek. The second one is the chickpeas. This one is cress again, the third one. The fourth one here is the radish. Fifth one is the moong. So these are, they grow really lovely, and each pot you can have like your breakfast with by spreading it on bread or whatever food you have. You can just garnish it as well. So we are going to talk about the recipes in the next slides. So different types of microgreens from different families can be grown easily. So the ones which I have highlighted here are normally used by me, and they grow very well in my hands. So I think they're very easy to grow. So from Brassicaceae family, I have used broccoli seeds, cress seeds, radish seeds, and others like cilantro, that is the coriander, and fenugreek is methi, chickpeas, moong beans. So these have grown very well. You can also try other seeds. You can so I'll tell you where you can get those in Germany. So, and what are the best practices to grow these microgreens? First and foremost thing is that you need good quality seeds. They should be organic. They should not be treated with any chemical, because it might lead to contamination or food poisoning. So you should be very careful while you're ordering the seeds. So here in the first picture, if you can see, I have ordered, I got these seeds from Dener. Dener is a shop which have garden tools and stuff. So they sell also a wide variety of seeds, and they're all bio. So you can get those. And for the people in India, they can get the seeds from amazon.in. You have to check if the seeds are good quality seeds, if they're untreated. This is, yeah. And then a contaminant free growth medium is to be taken to grow your seeds. This is very important point, because also the same thing, that you avoid food contamination or you avoid this food poisoning. And the medium which is used should be either soil or coco peat or compost which you have made in your home, or if you have ordered it from online. So normally I use coco peat, and today I tried soil, two days back actually, I tried soil also along with coco peat. So I would like to see the results or the differences between using soil and coco peat. And coco peat, if you want, you can order these from amazon.in. for people living in India, you can order this from Amazon. And you also have this coco peat mats, which are in 100 in number, and I don't know the price, but right now they say that it's unavailable in Amazon. But you can get these coco peat mats from Amazon, and that's very easy to grow. You can just soak these coco peat mats in water and then spread the seeds, and you have to sprinkle water every day. And the main thing you which you need to take care is that the soil should or the growth medium should be always hydrated, and the container of your choice. You can use whatever container you want. For example, I used a small glass bowl. So you can use whatever container you want. You can it depends on how many people are there in your house or how many members you want to share the these microgreens with, so on. Okay. And the first and important and the next important thing is that you have to soak the seeds in water overnight, or you know, as I said, fresh seeds which I have just now soaked doesn't need much time. It's better if you soak the seeds overnight. You will be pretty sure that they will germinate. And evenly spread the seeds and cover them with a thin layer of soil. This actually again sometimes I won't cover when I have used the coco peat. I don't cover the seeds with soil with coco peat or soil, because somehow it works really well. And today I have used soil as well. So soil I used and I have covered with one layer of soil after spreading the seeds. So I just want to have a look later on. I'll show you the pictures now. And so after you spread the seeds, you cover them with a thin layer of soil or coco peat. Spray water every day. You need to take much care while spraying water. You should not over water those plants, because those seeds, because then they get the germination would not become proper. So spray ample amount of water but not too much. And once the seedlings germinate, put them in sunlight or artificial light. So what I used to do is I used to soak the seeds and then spread them on the coco peat container, and then put them in my kitchen where there is little bit of light. So that's totally no problem, even if you are putting it in light or but not too much of amount of sunlight, you know, until they germinate. You should not put them put those plants in too much amount of sunlight. Yeah, so I will turn on my video and then I'll show you. So these are the pictures of the microgreens which I have used. And so here you can see I used 5 different types of microgreens. So this is a cress. This is one type of radish. This is another type of radish. This is methi or fenugreek. And this is one type of leafy vegetable. We call it totakura in our language. So I have tried this also. I don't know if how far this would be a success with this seed. So these are the two different mediums which I use. The first one is the soil. Second one is the coco peat. I have soaked this in water. And after the first day, so this was a look at my at the two of the trays. So I spread the seeds in this manner, all the seeds in one tray. Just wanted to try something new. It looked to see how they grow afterwards. And in the soil, I was not able to spread just like how I did on coco peat. So I need to sprinkle the seeds. And then I covered them with these covers which I got from Germany. But see, there is no need that you have to use all these sort of trays or whatsoever. You can just use whatever things you have, normal pots or trays or plates, whatever you have. There's no need that like you need to have this specific equipment to grow your microgreens. Okay, now I'll turn on my video and I'll show you how far they have grown. So the first ones here are the radish microgreens. You can see those sprouting out, and I can see the tiny leaflets, the first true leaves coming out here. If you can see properly, I don't know if you can see properly, but here I can see the second one is a cress. Just now we soaked these seeds, right? The second one is a cress. And the third one is the fenugreek or methi. And fourth one is again the cress. Fifth one is a different type of one is the leafy vegetable which we call totakura in our language. So I don't know if this works, but I wanted to just try. So this is how they look when you are seedlings. So So this is a soil. I have this is soil, and I can also see a bit of these. Some of these are sprouting out, but not very well, like how I did on cocoa peat. Can you see the difference?
Yes.
Yeah.
So these are the recipes which we tried, my husband and me, when we started growing these microgreens. So you can use these microgreens in salads, you can make smoothies out of these, and you can garnish on top of any curry or any rice item which you make. And you can use this on sandwiches. So here the picture of sandwiches, and also there are some recipes like you can take the mushrooms, you can bake them in oven, and then you can fill these mushrooms with some cheese and some microgreens and some vegetables, and then you can grab that mushroom, and you can eat it like one mushroom at a time. It's really yummy, it's really tasty. And with the sweet potato also, you just boil the sweet potato and then cut it into half, and you fill this with some microgreens, different varieties of microgreens, and add some lemon on top, and you garnish it with again some onions, some bell pepper, and add some salt and chili powder, and you eat this. It's also really, really tasty. So you can. So these are like different types of recipes. I mean, it depends on your creativity, how well you create the stuff. So you can create however you want and use these microgreens. They're the best and easy nutrient sources. And at the moment, because of this COVID-19 crisis, I would highly recommend you to get these seeds and grow those in your home to entertain your kids and to get nutrition as well. Okay, then. So I finish with this last slide. Can you please go to next slide, Jagadeesh? Jagadeesh, can you go? Yeah. So these are all the different microgreens which we actually have grown in when I was in Munich, and we shared this with lots of friends. So we gifted them to so many friends. So I would really love to have you guys growing these microgreens and sharing your pictures, sharing your photos on IEN. So that it would be really lovely to